Hello everyone and welcome to Vigyan Ghar's YouTube channel. Today we shall discuss the 2018 South Asian University Entrance Exam paper. South Asian University is an international university sponsored by the South Asian Association of Regional Cooperation, that is SAARC. It conducts this entrance exam for MSc Biotechnology course admissions. The paper has 100 questions and is divided into two sections. Part A has 30 questions and Part B has 70 questions. Today we will discuss the last 50 questions of Part B. In a normal distribution curve, mean is greater than median is greater than mode. Mean is lesser than median, which is lesser than mode. C, mean is equal to median, which is equal to mode. Or D, mean is equal to standard deviation. Now, first, we must understand what a normal distribution curve is. For that, please refer to this diagram. When you look at this diagram, this is normal distribution curve. This is a positively skewed curve and this is a negatively skewed curve. A normal distribution has perfectly symmetrical distribution. Here, the mean, median, and mode are equal. The area under normal distribution curve is equal to 1. The normal distributions are denser in the central part and less dense in the tails. Approximately 95% of this area of the normal distribution curve is within 2 standard deviations of the mean. So, here the mean is equal to median and is equal to mode. So, here the correct answer is option C. Which region of the marine habitat refers to the microscopic interface between water and air? A. Pelagic zone, B. Neustin, C. Euphotic zone, or D. Euphotic zone. For this, we will refer to this diagram. This is a diagram of the different zones in the marine habitat. Now, the question asks the microscopic interface between water and air. The layer that separates the water from air through an interface is the pelagic realm, as you can see here. It separates water and air. So here the correct answer is option A. The term mycology would be best applied to which of the following organisms listed below? A. Stromatolites, B. Baker's yeast, C. Cyanobacteria, or D. Slime molds. Now, when we use the term mycology, we primarily refer to fungi. In these options, if we go by elimination, the first option, that is stromatolites. Stromatolites are layered rock or microbial reefs which are made from blue-green algae, which is primarily a bacteria. So A is not the correct answer. Baker's yeast, that is Saccharomyces cerevisiae, is a fungi. It is a unicellular fungi. Cyanobacteria, as I've mentioned before, is a bacteria, blue-green alga. And lastly, slime molds are protists. So here, the correct answer is option B, Baker's yeast. Rhodophyta or red algae appear red due to A. Chlorophyll A, B. Chlorophyll B, C. Phycocyanin, or D. Phycoerythrin. Now, out of these options, phycoerythrin is a red protein pigment complex. It is from this family of phycobiliproteins. It is primarily found in red algae and acts as an accessory pigment to the main chlorophyll pigments that are responsible for photosynthesis. These pigments impart red color to the rhodophyta. So the correct answer is option D. Which one of the following is not a phylum among the archaea? A. Crenarchaeota, B. Euryarchaeota, C. Methanoarchaeota, or D. Nanoarchaeota. Now, there are 5 phyla among archaea. They are the first option, which is Crenarchaeota, Euryarchaeota, Corarchaeota, which is not mentioned here, Nanoarchaeota, and lastly Thaumarchaeota. Methanoarchaeota is not a phylum among archaea. So the correct answer is option C. In wastewater, the bacteria are packed together by filamentous dash to form sludge. A. Halophiles, B. Thermophiles, C. Methanogens, or D. Psychrophiles. Certain bacteria called as methanogens grow anaerobically on cellulosic material and are responsible to produce large amounts of methane along with carbon dioxide. These bacteria are commonly found in anaerobic sludge during sewage treatment. So here the correct answer is option C, that is methanogens. To screen a developing embryo for genetic aberrations or for sex determination, the fluid is collected from the A. amnion, B. chorion, C. allantois, or D. yolk sac. The process of screening or developing embryo is called as amniocentesis. In this process, the amniotic fluid is extracted by a needle through uterus through the amniotic sac. So, the correct answer is option A, that is amnion. The first complete genome of a cellular organism came out in 1995 and belonged to A. Arabidopsis thaliana, B. Saccharomyces cerevisiae, C. Caenorhabditis elegans, or D. Haemophilus influenza. The first organism to have its entire genome sequenced was Haemophilus influenzae in 1995. After it, the genomes of other bacteria and some other archaea were first sequenced, largely due to their small genome size. H. influenzae has a genome of 18,30,140 base pairs. So here the correct answer is option B. The characteristics that have arisen as a result of common evolutionary descent are said to be A. homogeneous, B. homologous, C. continuous, or D. parallel traits. Here, common evolutionary descent means common ancestry. So, the characteristics that have arisen as a result of common ancestry are called as homologous characteristics. So, here the correct answer is option D. Here is the next question. The science dealing with the application of the laws of heredity and genetics towards the improvement of human race is called A. Euthenics, B. Eugenics, C. Euphenics, or D. Ethnology. In these options, eugenics is a science that deals with the laws in heredity and genetics towards the improvement of human race. It promotes the inbreeding between individuals with favorable genes. So, the correct answer is option B. In the B form of DNA, there are 10 bases per turn of helix. Each base pair therefore rotates by an angle of A. 10 degree, B. 22 degree, C. 34 degree, or D. 36 degree. Now, one turn of helix is equal to 360 degrees. And the number of base pairs per turn in a B form of DNA is 10. This is given in the question. So, the angle rotated by each turn is equal to 360 divided by 10, which is equal to 36. So, here the correct answer is option D. The reverse transcription of eukaryotic mRNA can be achieved in vitro using the enzyme reverse transcriptase along with A. oligo-DA primers, B. oligo-DT primers, C. oligo-DC primers, or D. oligo-DU primers. Now, oligo-DT primers will amplify only mRNA with a poly-A tail. This is where the primer binds to promote reverse transcription. So here, the correct answer is option B, that is oligo-DT primers. Which one of the following amino acids is translationally incorporated, that is proteogenic in nature? A. hydroxyproline, B. acetyllysine, C. pyrrolysine, or D. hydroxyserine. Proteogenic amino acids are amino acids that are incorporated biosynthetically into proteins during translation. The word proteogenic means protein creating. Throughout known life, there are 22 genetically encoded proteogenic amino acids, 20 in the standard genetic code, and an additional 2 that are selenocysteine and pyrrolysine that can be incorporated by special translation mechanisms. So here, the correct answer is option C, that is pyrrolysine. Post-transcriptional modifications such as splicing occurs within the A. nucleus, B. cytoplasm, C. endoplasmic reticulum, or D. ribosomes. Post-transcriptional modifications are of pre-mRNA such as capping, splicing, and polyadenylation take place in the nucleus. After these modifications have been completed, the mature mRNA molecules have to be translocated into cytoplasm where the protein synthesis takes place. So here the correct answer is option A, that is nucleus. Here's the next question. Catalytic activity has been observed for which of the following species? A. DNA, B. mRNA, C. tRNA, or D. rRNA. Of these, DNA does not have a catalytic activity, which is actually a plus point as it gives it stability. Among these RNAs mentioned, rRNA has a catalytic activity. It has played a key role in early evolution. So here the correct answer is option D, that is rRNA. Chlorophyll absorbs A. green light, B. red and blue light, C. white light, or D. UV light. According to the absorption spectra of chlorophyll, it is seen that it absorbs light in red and blue wavelengths, that is long and short wavelengths of the light spectrum. Green light is not absorbed, but it is reflected, making the plant appear green. So the correct answer is option B. In vascular plants, sugar is transported through A. xylem, B. phloem, C. stomata, or D. mesophyll. In vascular plants, the process of transporting sugar is called as translocation, and it takes place in the phloem. So the process of transport of sugar is occurring through the phloem. So the correct answer is option B. Which chemotherapeutic or anti-cancer drug is produced by Caceranthus roseus? A. vincristine, B. taxol, C. fluorouracil, or D. colchicine. Now, taxol is from the plant Taxus. Fluorouracil is an analog of pyrimidine nucleoside. Colchicine is from colchicum, which is called as autumn crocus, and it is also from the plant Gloriosa superba. Here, in these options, vincristine is the only anti-cancer drug that is produced from Caceranthus roseus. So the correct answer is option A. Which one of the following acids is the natural phytohormone auxin present in plants? A. indole acetic acid, B. 1-naphthalene acetic acid, C. 2,4-dichlorophenoxyacetic acid, or D. 2,4,5-trichlorophenoxyacetic acid. Now, in these given options, the option B, C, and D, that is 1-naphthalene acetic acid, 2,4-dichlorophenoxyacetic acid, and 2,4,5-trichlorophenoxyacetic acid are synthetic auxins. Indole acetic acid is the natural auxin. So the correct answer is option A. Monocot plants have A. a network of veins in the leaf and vascular bundle in a ring, B. a network of veins in the leaf and scattered vascular bundle, C. parallel veins in the leaf and scattered vascular bundle, or D. parallel veins in the leaf and vascular bundle in a ring. Now, we know that the basic characteristic of venation in monocots is parallel venation. For dicots, it is reticulate venation, which means a network of veins. So, parallel venation in monocots is a characteristic. Now, for the vascular bundle, we will refer to this diagram. Here, we can see that the vascular bundles of the monocot plants are scattered. That is, the xylem and phloem are separate, as you can see here. So, the correct answer is option C, parallel veins in the leaf and scattered vascular bundle. Which one of the following plant hormones is not related to any stress? A. Ethylene, B. Salicylic acid, C. Abscisic acid, or D. Auxin. Now, ethylene is a plant hormone which is responsible for stress and senescence. It fastens ripening. And salicylic acid is responsible for abiotic stress. Abscisic acid is responsible for abscission. So out of these four options, auxin is not responsible for any, or it is not a stress-related plant hormone. So the correct answer is option D. Which of the following hormones causes cell elongation in internodal regions of green plants? A. ABA, that is abscisic acid. B. Auxin, C. Gibberellin, or D. Cytokinin. Now, if you take a quick overview of the main and the most important functions of these hormones, we will find that ABA is responsible for leaf abscission, auxins promote stem elongation and inhibit growth of lateral buds, that is, it maintains apical dominance. Cytokinins are responsible for lateral growth of the plant. Whereas gibberellins are responsible for internodal elongation in genetically dwarf plants. So here the correct answer is option C. Which one of the following is not a micronutrient for plants? A. Potassium, that is K. B. Sodium, that is Na. C. Fe, that is iron. Or D. Zn, that is zinc. Now, in plants, macronutrients are elements which require relatively large amounts, whereas micronutrients are those which are required in much smaller amounts. A combination of both, that is micro and macronutrients, gives the soil its optimum health. The macronutrients are nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, calcium, sulfur, magnesium, carbon, oxygen, and hydrogen. The micronutrients or the trace minerals which are mentioned in the question are iron, boron, chlorine, manganese, zinc, copper, molybdenum, and nickel. So out of these options, only potassium is a macronutrient, while sodium, iron, and zinc are micronutrients. So here the correct answer, that is the odd one out, is option A. Which one of the following statements regarding transgenic technology is not a myth? A. Transgenics have genes but normal plants do not. B. When we create transgenics, we don't exactly know the changes in the genetic level in plants. C. Transgenic plants or products are not organic or natural and are harmful for the system. Or D. Transgenes can easily spread through pollen, so transgenics should be grown with strict regulation and isolation. Now, out of these four options, A, B, and C are complete myths. However, option D is not a myth. One of the major concerns to introduce GM crops into environment is the flow of transgene containing pollen to the surroundings. This process is called pollen-mediated gene flow, which is itself a neutral process and occurs normally between conventional crops. It is of great importance in seed production, and the effect of this gene flow depends on the differences between the recipient and donor plants. It makes the movement of the introduced genes from the GM crops to other plants possible, which usually occurs if the GM pollen is delivered to the receptive stigma by insects or winds. Thus, these plants have to be grown with strict regulation and must be isolated to prevent this transfer wherever it is not needed. So the correct answer is option D. The DPT vaccine protects against A. Diphtheria, polio, tetanus, B. Diphtheria, pertussis and tetanus, सी डिप्थेरिया पर्ट्यूसिस एंड टाइफॉइड और डी डिप्थेरिया पोलियो एंड टाइफॉइड. नाउ इन द डीपीटी वैक्सीन डी पी एंड टी इटसेल्फ स्टैंड्स फॉर डिप्थेरिया पर्ट्यूसिस एंड टेटनस. सो द ऑप्शन बी इज द करेक्ट आंसर डिप्थेरिया पर्ट्यूसिस टेटनस. In India, Kalaazar is caused by A. Leishmania donovani, B. Leishmania tropica, C. Leishmania major, or D. Leishmania shigasi. Kalaazar, also called as black fever, is a disease caused by infection of Leishmania parasites. Visceral leishmaniasis is spread by sandfly bites, and this type of leishmaniasis affects the internal organs, usually the spleen, liver and bone marrow. Now, in India, only one species, that is Leishmania donovani, primarily infects individuals and attacks the reticuloendothelial system. So here, the correct answer is option A, that is Leishmania donovani. Virus-mediated transfer of cellular genetic material from one bacterial cell to another is called A. Transfection, B. Transduction, C. Transformation, or D. Transposition. Now here, transfection is the introduction of a small molecule such as DNA or RNA or antibodies into eukaryotic cells, most preferably animal cells. Transformation here refers to the uptake of DNA from the environment by a bacterial cell. Transposition, on the other hand, is the transfer of a segment of DNA from one site to another site in the genome. Here, transduction means the transfer of cellular genetic material from one bacterial cell to another via a virus. So, the correct answer is option B. Peptidoglycan is a polymer comprising all except A. N-acetyl glucosamine, B. N-acetyl muramic acid, C. N-acetyl muraminic acid, or D. Sialic acid. Now, for this, we refer this diagram, which is the structure of a peptidoglycan molecule. As you can see clearly, it is a polymer made from repeating units of N-acetyl glucosamine and N-acetyl muramic acid. It does not contain N-acetyl muraminic acid, or which is also called as sialic acid. So, these two are not present. So, the correct answer is option C and D are not a part of peptidoglycan polymer. Which one of the following is a class of RNA viruses? A. Adenoviruses and herpes viruses, B. Pox viruses, C. Parvoviruses, or D. Coronaviruses and picornaviruses. For this, we refer this table. From here, we can see that adenovirus, herpes virus, and pox viruses are a class of double-stranded DNA viruses. Parvoviruses mentioned here in the third option are single-stranded DNA viruses. Picornavirus is a single-stranded positive sense RNA virus, and so is coronavirus. So, the correct answer for a class of RNA viruses is D, coronaviruses and picornaviruses. A messenger RNA is 336 nucleotides long, including the initiator and termination codons. The number of amino acids in the protein translated from this mRNA is A, 999, B, 630, C, 112, or D, 111. Now, for a initiator and termination codons, initiator codons are sense codons, so they will code for a particular amino acid, whereas termination codons are non-sense codons and will not code for an amino acid. One codon has three nucleotides. So now, we will refer to this. The number of nucleotides in total in the RNA are 336. The number of coding nucleotides are 336 minus 3 because the termination codon is non-coding. So this is 333. As I mentioned earlier, the number of nucleotides in a codon is 3 and one codon corresponds to one amino acid. So the total number of amino acids will be 333 divided by 3, which is equal to 111. So the correct answer is option D. For ultra high temperature, that is UHT treatment of milk, to increase its shelf life up to 6 months, milk is heated to A, 87.8 degrees Celsius for 30 minutes, B, 71.6 degrees Celsius for 30 seconds, C, 87.8 degrees Celsius for 3 seconds, or D, 71.6 degrees Celsius for 15 seconds. Ultra high temperature treatment of milk is also called as HTST treatment, that is high temperature short time. The temperature specified for this is 71.6 degrees Celsius, which is approximately 72 degrees Celsius, and the treatment is at for 50 second intervals each. So the answer is option D. The process of formation of nitrate from ammonia is known as A, nitrate assimilation, B, nitrification, C, ammonia assimilation, or D, denitrification. Now, if we refer to this chart here, we can clearly see that the process of formation of nitrate from ammonia is known as nitrification. So, ammonia first forms nitrite, which then forms nitrate. Similarly, the process in which nitrate is converted into nitrogen is called as denitrification. So nitrate gets converted into nitrite, which gets converted into nitric oxide, which gets converted into nitrous oxide to finally give nitrogen. Ammonia assimilation is defined as incorporation of ammonia into organic compounds. And nitrate assimilation is the process by which inorganic nitrogen is converted to ammonia and hence to organic nitrogen. So here the correct answer is option B. Chloroplast contains disc-like membranous structures arranged in a sac, is called A, cisternae, B, grana, C, stroma, or D, thylakoids. To understand this, we have a diagram of a structure of a chloroplast. Now, chloroplast has disc-like membranous structures. So, these disc-like membranous structures are called as thylakoids. Stacks of thylakoids are called as grana. So, the correct option here is option D. The disc-like membranous structures are called as thylakoids. Which one of the following viruses binds with alpha 2 microglobulin? A, HIV, B, Epstein-Barr virus, C, hepatitis A, or D, rhinovirus. Now, alpha 2 macroglobulin is cleaved by human immunodeficiency virus 1 protease. The cleavage site is phenylalanine 684 and tyrosine 685 bond in the bait region and exposed part of alpha 2 microglobulin creating the F form. So here the correct answer is option A, HIV. Which one of the following statements best describes why intermediate filaments cannot participate in the generation of pores for cell motility? A, they are not intrinsically polar and hence cannot utilize motor proteins. B, cells are unable to control the assembly. C, they cannot disassemble. D, they are found in association with certain cell junctions. Intermediate filaments consist of several intertwined strands of fibrous proteins. Intermediate filaments do not have any role in cell movement. Their function is purely structural. They bear tension, thus maintaining the shape of the cell and anchor the nucleus and other organelles in place. They are so named because they are thicker than actin filaments and thinner than microtubules or muscle myosin filaments. As a result, the overall filament has no polarity, and thus motor proteins cannot move along the intermediate filaments. So the correct answer is option A. In which form are carbohydrates present in plasma lemma? A. Cellulose, B. Hemicellulose, C. Starch, or D. Glycolipids and glycoproteins. Now, lipid and proteins on the cell membrane surface often have short carbohydrate chains protruding out from the cell surface. These are known as glycolipids and glycoproteins. They form hydrogen bonds with water molecules surrounding the cell and help to stabilize the membrane structure. They can also serve as antibodies, which are used in allowing cells to recognize each other. So the correct answer is option D. What is the major function of smooth endoplasmic reticulum? A. Lipid synthesis, B. Protein synthesis, C. Carbohydrate synthesis, or D. Amino acid synthesis. The major function of smooth endoplasmic reticulum is lipid synthesis. Protein synthesis is carried out by the rough endoplasmic reticulum. So here the correct answer is option A, lipid synthesis. Which one of the following organelles is called as the sorting center of the cell? A. Rough endoplasmic reticulum, B. Smooth endoplasmic reticulum, C. Golgi apparatus, or D. Lysosome. Now, the Golgi apparatus carries out works such as sorting, tagging, packaging, and distribution of components within the cell. Thus, it is called as the sorting center of the cell. So, the correct answer is option C. Which one of the following is a cell surface carbohydrate binding protein? A. Cadherin, B. Integrin, C. Selectin, or D. Elastin. Cadherin is a calcium-dependent adhesion protein. Integrin helps in the binding of cell and extracellular matrix, that is ECM. Selectin, which is also called as lectin, is a cell surface carbohydrate binding protein. And elastin is a protein of extracellular matrix. So here, the correct option is option C, that is selectin. Cellular totipotency means the A. Capacity of a plant cell to form a complete plant, B. Formation of a new plant, C. Formation of new cell, or D. Formation of new species. Totipotency is the ability of a single cell to divide and produce all the differentiated cells in the organism. Examples of totipotent cells are spores and zygotes. The capacity to generate a whole plant from a single plant cell is thus called totipotency. In fact, a whole plant can be regenerated from any plant part, which is called as an explant in tissue culture. So here the correct answer is option A. Which one of the following cyclins and cyclin-dependent kinases initiate centrosomes duplication during cell cycle? A. Cyclin E and CDK2, B. D and CDK4 or 6, C. A and CDK2, or D. B and CDC2. For this, we will refer to this diagram. As you can see, the transition from G1 to S, that is the synthesis phase, that is the growth phase 1 and synthesis phase, is carried out by cyclin E and CDK2. They are also responsible in the initiation of centrosome duplication. However, in the absence of cyclin E, cyclin A initiates the duplication of centrosomes along with CDK2. But originally, it is a function of cyclin E and CDK2. So the correct answer is option A, cyclin E and CDK2. Which one of the following drugs is a microfilament inhibitor? A. Aspirin, B. Colchicin, C. Cyclohexamide, or D. Cytoxylazin B. In these given options, cytoxylazin B blocks the monomer addition to actin filaments towards its fast growing ends. does? It inhibits microfilaments. So the correct answer is option D, that is cytochalasin B. Which one of the following cell adhesion junctions is called hemidesmosome? A. Cell-cell adhesion junction supported by microfilaments. B. Cell-cell adhesion junction supported by intermediate filaments. C. Cell matrix junction supported by intermediate filaments. Or D. Cell matrix junction supported by microfilaments. The cell-cell adhesion junction supported by microfilaments is termed as adherence junction. The cell-cell adhesion junction supported by intermediate filaments are called desmosomes. The cell matrix junction supported by intermediate filaments is called hemidesmosomes. And the cell matrix junction supported by microfilaments is called actin-linked cell matrix junction. So, in the question, they have asked cell adhesion junction, which is called as hemidesmosomes. So, option C is called as a hemidesmosome. The correct answer is option C. Which of the following cells belong to the category of professional antigen presenting cells? A. Epithelial cells. B. Dendritic cells. C. Neutrophils. Or D. Endothelial cells. The category of professional antigen presenting cells includes dendritic cells, macrophages, and B cells, that is B lymphocytes. In the given options, dendritic cells are the only ones which belong to the category of antigen presenting cells. So the correct answer is option D, that is dendritic cells. In which of the following transplantations, tissue typing is not needed? A. Kidney transplantation. B. Blood transfusion. C. Liver transplantation. Or D. Skin transplantation. Tissue typing is a procedure in which tissues of a prospective donor and recipient are tested for compatibility prior to transplantation. A mismatched donor and recipient tissues can lead to rejection of these tissues, which is called as graft rejection. Skin grafting or skin transplantation is a surgical procedure that involves removal of skin from one area of the body and moving it or transplanting it to a different area of the body. This surgery may be done if a part of your body has lost its protective covering of dermis due to burns, injuries, or illness. For this process, since it is of the same individual, tissue typing is not required. So the correct answer is option D, that is skin transplantation. Indel mutations can be brought about by the action of all of the following except A. 5-bromouracil, B. Acridin, C. Intercalating agents, or D. Gene transposition. Indel mutations, the term indel comes from insertions and deletions. Now these are referred to as point or frame shift mutations. Out of these options, 5-bromouracil introduces a point mutation. Acridin induces addition or deletion mutations, which are also frame shift mutations. Intercalating agents also are responsible for frame shift mutations. Gene transposition, however, refers to complete jumps in a gene. So a gene from one area moves to another area within the genome. So option D is the odd man out. So the correct answer is option D. Propagation of action potential across a myelinated axon is known as A. Wallerian degeneration, B. Synaptic integration, C. Saltatory conduction, or D. Neurotransmission. Here is a diagram of both a myelinated and unmyelinated axon. As you can see, in a myelinated axon, the action potential travels from one node of Ranvier to another. There is a constant jump. This process is called as a saltatory conduction. So the correct answer is option C, that is saltatory conduction in a myelinated axon. A non-myelinated axon has direct transmission. When the contribution of two mutations to the phenotype of a double mutant exceeds the expectation from the combined effects of the individual mutations, it is called A. additive interaction, B. synergistic interaction, C. antagonistic interaction, or D. complementation. Synergistic interactions occur when the combined effect is greater than the sum of individual effects. So multiple stressors produce a cumulative effect that are greater than the additive sum of these effects. This is called as synergistic interaction. So the correct answer here is option B. Antagonistic interaction is completely opposite to this, which means a cumulative effect which has less than additive result. Which one of the following groups of scientists discovered the direct link between genes and enzymatic reactions? A. Oswald Avery, Colin McLeod, and Macklin McCarty. C. Rosalind Franklin and Maurice Wilkins. C. George Beadle and Edward Tatum. Or D. Maurice Wilkins, James Watson, and Francis Crick. Now, Oswald Avery, Colin McLeod, and Macklin McCarty were responsible to prove that DNA is the genetic material. Rosalind Franklin and Maurice Wilkins are known for the work on X-ray diffraction images of DNA. Maurice Wilkins, James Watson, and Francis Crick are credited with the discovery of the double-stranded helical structure of the DNA, whereas George Beadle and Edward Tatum, through experiments on the red bread mold, that is Neurospora crassa, showed that the genes act by regulating distinct chemical events, affirming the one gene, one enzyme hypothesis. So they are the ones who discovered a direct link between genes and enzymatic reactions. So the correct answer is option C, George Beadle and Edward Tatum. Plasmid DNA can be specifically isolated from bacterial cultures without genomic DNA contamination through A. phenol chloroform separation, B. alkaline lysis method, C. treatment with DNases, or D. affinity chromatography. Here, in the first option, phenol chloroform separation is a technique used to obtain nucleic acids, that is DNA or RNA, by separating it from proteins and lipids in a liquid-liquid extraction technique. However, the process in which plasmid DNA is specifically isolated is called as alkaline lysis method. It is a widely used method for extraction of plasmid DNA by separating it from chromosomal DNA based on its small size and the supercoiled nature of plasmids. The alkaline conditions help to denature the DNA. Here, the plasmid DNA gets renatured quickly because of its supercoiled nature and small size, but the genomic nature cannot be renatured. Genomic DNA cannot be renatured. So the correct answer is option B, that is alkaline lysis method. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe to Vigyan Ghar's YouTube channel for more such videos. Thank you.